Depending on the people.
No, but I mean, it's normal to do that. In other countries, it's normal to walk in the streets with bikinis.
Well, it's normal in this country to show your body as well. But if you go and look in certain places in the United Kingdom where they have nuns,
yes,
they can easily identify that this woman has devoted her life to God Almighty.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? So this is not only modesty, but it's also an identity of the nun, that who she is compared to the other women in her community, in her society. The same with the Muslim women. So there are Muslim women who cover with hijab, or some of them with niqab.
Yes.
Both of them are showing people that not only modesty, not only this is a command from Allah, but this is our identity as a Muslimah.
Okay, where is that now in the ulama?
This,
where do they say that?
The ulama, yeah. This is something which all of them, I think, agree upon. That this is not only for modesty. The most important thing is a command from Allah. Yes?
That's the thing.
The most important
thing. What we know, we have the Quran.
Yes.
To understand the Quran, we go to the Hadith.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what it is, basically. Yeah. We have the Quran.
Well, we got the Quran, we got the Hadith, we got the biography of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Seerah.
Yes,
we got the ulama, obviously.
No, but the essentials, I mean.
No, the ulama are essential. Allah says in the Quran, if you don't know, ask the people
ask
of knowledge. Exactly.
Yeah, but
so the ulama are an integral part of the Sharia. You cannot take them out of the equation. Without the ulama, who's going to do the tafsir?
No, but
who's going to
the
explain
tafsir was clear.
No.
No, about
the reason
the hijab, what I'm talking about, hijab, the tafsir was clear. You don't need to go to alim.
So what is clear to you?
What's clear to me is...
Whom is the hijab for, according to you, based on the Quran only?
Based on the Quran, Nisa al-Mu'minat, but Zawjat al-Rasul.
You see what I mean? So your saying is only for the Ummahat al-Mu'minun.
Yes.
Yes? Now, that is your understanding.
Yeah.
But as ulama, they'll give you a different understanding.
They say everybody.
No. They say every Muslim,
yeah.
Yes, who follows the command of Allah, maintains modesty,
okay,
and an identity of a Muslim. This is something which you have to understand based on not just the Quran, but the other ayats in the Quran, plus the Hadith, plus the Seerah, plus the life of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's family and so on. It's all of that. You see what I mean? So you cannot say the tafsir is clear. You have to understand the nuances within the Quran as to how the Sharia is formed.
I need extra tafsir, basically, just to get to the details. You know what I mean?
Say again?
Like
the tafsir is
just what I said. We need to go into details just to find out these
You have
points,
to. You have to, because the deen is not something that you can just read and make up your mind based on it. Because many people read and they get a wrong impression about what it is, or they get the wrong limitation about it. You see what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you
so
mean.
So there are many things which are very clear in the Quran, but many things which are not explained in detail. For which you have to go and rely upon the Hadith, rely upon the Seerah, rely upon the understanding of the ulama. Because I would rather take my deen from the understanding of someone who is close to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or an alim, rather than some lay person who's talking about just reading something in Arabic and saying, this is what it means. Because they can be wrong. They don't have the experience or the knowledge.
Many Muslims now, as of today, they don't wear hijab. Many of them.
And what does that mean?
That's what I'm asking.
There are many Muslims who drink alcohol.
Yeah.
There are many Muslims who have boyfriends and girlfriends. There are many Muslims who fornicate. That doesn't justify anything, does it? If Allah had made it a command from the Quran and they disobeyed, then they will have to account on Yawm al-Qiyamah.
Even when
just because something is in vogue, something is in fashion, that doesn't mean it becomes halal. You see what I mean?
No.
For us, the deen comes from Allah, call Allah wa call Rasul.
But the only problem today we have is there is too many fatwas coming out. They make you not think right.
You don't have to go to everyone who gives a fatwa. At least stick to the ones who are credible alims, you know.
Yeah, but I mean
that
today
should be sufficient,
what basically starts driving me crazy and start making me think a lot.
Yeah.
Because many fatwas really starts like you can't accept them, you know? Like new fatwas. Things you know.
Well, I can't talk about things which are
in. No, what I mean, that's why there are many corruption now in the Muslim community, you know?
Yeah,
because of these weird fatwas.
I just told you that there are things in the Muslim community which are unacceptable. That doesn't justify anything. So even if some alim, or he calls himself a scholar, and he gives a particular fatwa, That doesn't mean that every single alim in the world is going to accept his fatwa. Yeah. Yes?
Yeah, right.
So they will say, if it is wrong, they themselves will say that no, do not follow this. And these are the reasons you basically reject it. So we have already safety net for that. Within the same ulama who are the credible ones.